All right, Phillip. So when we were out at the wetlands, we kept seeing all these little plastic traps, and you had explained how scientists use these to catch the critters that are in the water.
Cut off this extra one.
Tell us a little bit about how to make these traps, how to make them right.
So yeah, if you'll recall, you know, I mentioned these are often used to catch either minnows, or you can catch tadpoles, or you can catch wetland invertebrates in them, and they are just made out of 2-liter bottles. They're super easy to make, obviously really cheap, and that's why we like them. They'll last a long time in the water because they're just made of plastic.
Right.
But if you'll recall, obviously I talked about making sure you pick these things up because it is a trap and they do catch animals. So make sure if you are going to put these out, you make sure you go get them. So if you put 10 out, make sure you get 10 back. But let's talk about how to make them properly.
Okay.
So start with, to make one trap, you're going to need 2 2-liter bottles. And what I'm going to start by doing is on one of those bottles, I need to cut the bottom off.
And okay.
There's a nice little line that you can usually follow to try to keep somewhat straight. We'll see if I can do that.
Now, some of the traps that we had seen, it looks like they had cut this end off.
Yeah, you know, the ones out in the field, they had only made them out of one bottle. They must have been really lacking on 2-liter bottles. And one way you can do it is to just cut the top off, invert it, put it back down, and then secure on the perimeter.
Uh-huh.
But then you don't have a great way to really get the animals out.
Oh,
so,
okay.
What I'm going to do is I cut around the bottom, and this creates the chamber.
Okay.
And then I'm going to take the next bottle and just use the top of it as the funnel, and it's going to get put into there. And then, using this cap that already comes right on there, I can use that as a funnel to kind of pour the critters out that
I'm catching. Dump them out that way.
Yep.
Okay.
So hopefully we'll be able to improve on the design that we found out there.
Okay.
So on this one, again, there's usually some sort of nice line right where the top of the label would have been, and I'm just going to cut right along that. If there's a spot to mess up in this process, I would say that it's not giving yourself enough of the funnel. So don't cut up too close to the top.
Gotcha.
Because it won't fit into the other side of your other 2-liter.
You need it to fit in the size of this cylinder.
Exactly.
Down here.
Okay. Yep. Cuts don't need to necessarily be perfectly straight because you should, again, be able to kind of fit it right into there. So we'll see how good I can do. Oops. Okay.
Looks good so far.
So, not perfect, but what we got is the funnel for our trap.
Okay.
So, it is going to be a type of funnel trap. And then this just goes straight into there. Notice we're leaving the cap off of this one this time.
Okay.
Fits right in there. And then you just have to secure that. I prefer using staples because staples won't really fall off very quickly when you got it in the water. If you just have duct tape on hand, you can usually use duct tape, but something to secure it. So what I'm gonna do is just kind of staple around the outside. A couple more for fun. And what you've got is a nice little minnow trap. And that's basically all there is to it.
Okay.
The one other step that you may want to take, instead of just chucking it into the water, you may want to give yourself a length of rope, or if you've just got fishing line on hand, something to tie them off with. We've got some rope in this case.
Okay.
So I would just tie this around the head of this side of the trap. Make sure you give yourself a good knot so it's going to stay put. And then you can either tie it to a rock on the bottom if it's going to be in deeper water, or if you can tie it to the edge, something that you can find it later. And often you will want to put some maybe pink flagging, or if you've got it, something bright and colorful that you're going to be able to find it. Because again, if you're going to be putting these out in the water, it's going to catch animals, and you want to make sure you can retrieve them. So
excellent.
Have a way to retrieve them.
Now, do you bait this or do you just leave it open?
No, most of the stuff that's gonna wind up in here is just going to do so on its own accord. You don't need to have any sort of attractant in there. What they do is if you put this, especially like up against vegetation or up against the side of the wetland. They may be swimming along the edge, and then once they hit the edge of this, they're going to continue on their way thinking it's the edge of something, and then soon enough they're going to end up into the chamber of your trap.
Okay.
So, yep, that's about all there is to it.
But the important thing is to remember is if you put 10 out, you get 10 back.
Make sure you get them back. I don't want to be finding them in the field with a bunch of dead animals in there later on.
Excellent. All right.
I'm John Davis, and we're in the field in Waco, Texas. Right here. In the field. In Waco. Help! How's that?